itself, the tourism industry itself, and the opportunity that Ghana has. Ghana is the most stable country in West Africa, one. Two, the most peaceful country. Three, it has abundant human resources. Four, there are a lot of opportunities. We have warm, welcoming people. We have different types of tourists. We have business tourists. We have leisure tourists. We have educational tourists. We have medical tourists. And we also have cultural heritage tourism. Now you need to know the categories or the classifications of the tourists who are coming and see whether you can fit in their expectation. But you need to learn, you need to study. Not only the academic course, you need to know the environment. You need to know history. If you want to do tourism, you must know history. Because if you take heritage tourism, for instance, you should be able to talk about the transatlantic slave trade. Now, Brazil and Nigeria are the two countries that hold a huge number of black people in the world. So how come Brazilians are colored and black? History will tell you that the transatlantic slave trade is sent a lot of blacks to the South America and the Caribbean. And most of these Brazilians come from Gold Coast. Now, when you have a knowledge over the industry that you have studied, it gives you a competitive edge. So don't just be stuck by the academic work, but be passionate about it. Read and learn from other sources. Enrich your knowledge reservoir. So that when opportunity strikes, you'll be able to present yourself well. There are huge opportunities in tourism. There are huge opportunities in hospitality. Tourism is Ghana's number four GDP earner. After one, cocoa. Two, crude oil. Three, crude oil. So how come it's not in your benefit to us? If you go to Kenya, South Africa, Botswana, Cairo, Dubai, Mauritius, Seychelles, they know tourism. They understand tourism. A common taxi driver knows the history of his country. And he can drive you and tell you, in any year, on the campus of university, Kenya University, you should be able to know how faculties, you know, came up. You can talk people here because this is an attraction. No, it is man-made attraction. University of Science and Technology, Public University of Science and Technology, is a tourist attraction. Don't see tourist attractions as the natural and heritage castles, waterfalls. No. There are artificial attractions. Anything that pulls you, draws you, drives you from your home or your place of home for you to come and experience something is an attraction. Why did you decide to come to KNUST, not Gilbert? Because you also run a tourism program. Because of the image of KNUST. You know that it's a high reputable institution. So when you come to destination management, there are certain factors we call the destination image, the destination price, the competitive advantage, and all that. But that's not what I'm saying. What I want you to focus on is that even here on KNUST campus, there are huge opportunities for you. You can even serve as a tour guide. Okay, I talked about the peace and stability. We have a sustainable tourism industry. Why do I say so? Okay. Tourism is a sector, and it it has industries. What are some of the industries we have at our tourism? We have transport, we have hospitality, we have food and beverages, we have aviation, we have telecommunication, then come again. Yes, we have creative arts, that's music, movie. So tourism is huge. When we say tourism, it's not just going to the beaches, the mountains, the forest, you know, game parks. No, it's a sector which has several industries. Because if you come to food and beverages, it's an industry on its own. If you come to hospitality, it's an industry on its own. If you come to transport, it's an industry on its own. If you come to creative arts, music, it's an industry on its own. And tourism overlaps or sits on all these industries. So it's a sector that encompasses all the industries. And that is why it's giving Ghana the fourth GDP, you know, revenue after cocoa, gold, and oil. So we have a sustainable tourism industry. We have unique traditions and social events. Now, after this presentation, I'm going to give you some specific sites to visit that will also enrich your knowledge. Now, there is a site called heritage.com. Heritage.com. Now, about 2 months ago, I chanced on two tourists, two black Americans from the USA who came to Ghana. And through the heritage.com, it had analyzed their roots, that they are 85% from West Africa. And out of West Africa, where transatlantic slave trade took place, most is Ghana or Gold Coast. So now they have identified their roots. If we have knowledgeable people in tourism, how do we integrate and connect these people into our society? We need some homes to get them connected to. A mother and her daughter, they have traced their route to Ghana. The daughter wanted to go to the Francophone, but the mom said, no, let's come here. Now, I saw them in my hotel. I picked them, taught them, gave them a deep insight of our history and how the transatlantic slave trade took place. And they feel so welcome and they want to even come and stay in Ghana. So we have unique traditions, we have all over the world. See how we marry. In the developed countries, if you want to marry, it's so simple. You propose to the lady, she accepts, you go to the registrar court, you register within 5 minutes, you're married. With or without witnesses, you're married. But our customary laws is not like that. In fact, the laws are such that before a wedding, ordinance, marriage will be recognized, you must have satisfied the customary law, which is the traditional agreement. Look at how the ceremony is done. You have to do knocking. They have to accept you. They have to give you lists, including brassiers and panties. You have to buy all these things. There's a machiami who has to lead you to present the items. Where in this world can you find this culture? Well, Abeiku Santana, where in this world? Where in the world? Where? Tell me. In America, UK, Canada, Australia, Germany, France, Italy. Where? So we have a unique culture. So if you want to be a tourism, you know, expert or tourism, you know, professional, you need to know how unique we are. Our marriage, how we marry alone is unique. And it's an attraction. See the way we carry babies on our back. It's an attraction. So beautiful. You can't find this in China. They don't carry babies on their back. See how we tie clothes around us and wash is an attraction. Funeral, an attraction. And these are the unique things that the inbound foreigners want to come and see. Because they have never seen this before. So this is also part of tourism. It is not just going to the forest and the beaches. This is also part of tourism. And if you find out the purpose for which the tourists are coming, but when you get to the airport, we have a form we call the disembarkation form. On that form, from the immigration, you tell why you're visiting the destination. Is it for business, meeting, conference, tourism? And it's important that we get this data, analyze the data, know the number of people who came for heritage, culture, medical, leisure, education, so that it helps us to build strong policies that will help our tourism industry or sector to thrive or grow. And this is something that we don't have. Now, if you go to a country called Sao Tome and Principe, how many of you have heard Sao Tome and Principe? Okay, it's becoming popular in Ghana for the past 3 years. I tell you why. Sao Tome is an island with a population of 120,000. In 1421, João de Santarém and Pedro de Escobar, the two Portuguese who were discovering West Coast Africa, coming to West Coast Africa, they stopped at São Tomé and Príncipe before they landed on the coast of Ghana, then Gold Coast, and Vina. If anybody tells you that Diabo de Azambu, Diabo was the first European to have arrived on the shores of Gold Coast, that is not true. Diabo de Azambu was an ex-convict, you know, from Europe, but it was the research that Pedro de Escobar and João de Santarém discovered. They actually found alluvial gold on the shores of El Mina and sent information to their governor. Then Diabo de Azambu came in disguise of setting up a trade post. And that's why with time, they started, why did they build the Elmina Castle? In 1471, the castle had been built. It was a kingdom where they would buy their goods and store them, and when the ship vessel comes, they send them away. But with time, they started training human beings, sending them away. Now, how many European empires came here? Portuguese, the Swedish, the Danish, the Dutch, then the British. The British were the last in 1665. They came through the disguise of the royal adventurers, the Navy, the British Navy, the same way. And when they came, they built the King's Castle. But later, they bought the Elmina Castle. And they also bought the Fort Osu and changed the name from Fort Osu to Christopher Castle. They built the Osha Fort. Some people even think that slave trade took place only in Asimbraso, but even in Accra. If you know Jamestown, if you know where Osha Fort is, when you cross the road, there's a market called Sara Market. The original name is Saraka Market. Slaves were brought from the North Saraka and they were kept in that small confine in chains and shackles. Then later they would transport them to the Osha Fort Castle. Then they take them away. So even in Accra, there was slave trade. Unfortunately, we have destroyed all our heritage sites. So even if you talk about the history, you can't find it, except archaeologists who have gone deep to discover, to tell us. I'm going to Israel in December, and you see the old city of Jerusalem, the stones that was built by David, is there. They will tell you that the rocks you see beneath, and we're talking over 4,000 years ago, because the story of Jesus Christ is only 2,000 years ago. They have conserved it. So when people read about these things, they want to come and see. They want to come and experience. Now, we have a lot of social events, which are also touristic activities. The only challenge we have in Ghana is the experience, the service. If I'm coming from America, you want to tell me that I haven't seen a five-star hotel better than Kempinski? So it is not about the hotel, it's not about the facility, it's about the service. I'm coming from Kenya recently. I ordered for drink, then ordered for my food. When they served the food, and I started eating, the waiter came again. I hope you enjoyed the food. Okay, I'm not far. If anything, please let me know. Thank you. Karimu, karimu. When you see your drink, you know, getting empty in the bottle, they come again. I said, can I have one more? If you would drink, I would drink. They are so nice. At the airport, I was waiting for my host. A driver approached me. Karimu, karimu. I say, karimu. Hi, my brother, how are you? He said, I'm fine. Ah, you coming to Nairobi? Is your first time here? I said, no. Nairobi, Kenya is my second. Oh, you waiting for your host, right? Say this. Do you have a phone to call him? I said, no. How can my phone? You have the number, give my phone. I called with his phone. My host came to pick me and he told me that you definitely need a driver, you know, during your visit. I just get my card. Anytime you need a driver, just call me, I'll come and pick you. They have been taught tourism that tourism is the sex, is the experience. So, telling you this experience, you love to go to Kenya, right? Won't you? So, we need people to also come here and go back and tell a good experience. Now, because of modern applications like TripAdvisor, if you go on TripAdvisor, you will hear what people are saying, the comment, the reviews about the attractions they are visiting. We have not trained ourselves so much well that even if you go to a restaurant and you ask for, madam, let me commend your admin assistant. When she asks, can I serve you water? I say, yes, please. She asks, room temperature or chill? I say, room temperature. But in Ghana, maybe I don't like cold food. I go to a restaurant. Please give me cook. You will bring me chill cook. Sometimes even ice block. You go to a restaurant. You order for food. You take the menu. Order for food. What do you want? I said, okay, give me bamboo, the okra stew and fish. Okay. Then the waitress will go. Then come back and tell you, I'm sorry, you mean you was. So why did you give it? So you should have known whether you know the menu available or not. You get a menu and they have all forms of drinks. Cognac, whiskey, what that you? You order a hotel. But to ask somebody, yes, if you need it. Then you wonder, so which one should you order again? So the service is bad. The service is bad. And one bad attitude. When you pay your bill, you pretend that they have forgotten to bring the change. As for celebrities, it has happened to us almost every day. But you don't need the I will come for you. Even if it's not possible. Now, some people are deliberate. They know that you're a public figure. So, you not demand for your 60 cedis change. I'll take it. I paid 20 cedis, was left with my change. The waiter didn't want to bring it for more than 30 minutes. I said, Master, this is our way. I said, oh, sorry. I said, oh, wait, sorry. Come on, you see, these are some of the things. It doesn't happen anywhere. Serve well. When you serve well, and your service is exceptionally good, you'll be rewarded because tips are legal. Tips are allowed in developed countries. But you must say, a waiter will see people coming or guests and customers coming, they will approach you. Hi, sir, even if you have kids, hello, sometimes they even go to the extent of giving the kids some candies. All right, please, table for family four, please wait for me. Go and set a table for you. Come and see that. Hi, my name is Bright. Okay, please, this is our drinks menu. What can I say? You take it. See, it must be your point. So in a service, when you have the passion to serve and be exceptionally good in what you do, people always come for you. So, my brothers and sisters, this is my simple story, that there's a huge opportunity in the tourism and hospitality industry. Get ready, be prepared, start networking, form teams, learn, research their new applications, read reviews of those applications, and see how best you can fit in. Thank you very much. That's it.